Gregg Popovich is not the main reason five championship banners hang at the AT&T Center. And he'll be the first to tell you that. In fact, when you try to give him such credit, he won't acknowledge it, brush it off, call it nonsense. If the U.S. goes on to win basketball gold at this summer's Olympics, Pop won't be the main reason. So why is everything Pop's fault now? Now, I get that some perceive there's a little bit of LeBron syndrome going on. People give credit when he wins, go so far as to call him the greatest of all time, but make excuses when he loses. Here's the thing, though. Pop hasn't lost much. He really hasn't. Over the last 24 years, the Spurs' worst seasons, these last two, have seen them still in the playoff hunt to the very last day. You won't find an NBA franchise outside of maybe the Lakers who wouldn't trade the last quarter century with Pop. Team USA hasn't lost a game that counts this summer. And while they finished 7th at the FIBA World Cup 2 years ago, they did so with Kemba Walker and a young Donovan Mitchell as their best player. Call me a Pop apologist if you'd like. That's fine. But I know this. The current Spurs roster is made up of young, not yet totally proven talent with the best player who spent the last 3 years trying to find his way. The national team is made up of proven talent and players who haven't spent their last 3 years trying to find their way to the national program. Blame Pop for all of that? He won't say it, but I will. And I'll borrow his sentiment when addressing such a claim. It's nonsense.